1939년부터 45년까지 폴란드 아우슈비츠를 비롯한 독일 여러 곳에 설치된 포로 수용소에서 독일 나치 히틀러에 의해서 600만 명이나 되는 유대인들이 끔찍하게 희생당한 일을 바로 홀로코스트라고 하죠. 말이 600만 명이지 그 엄청난 숫자의 유대인들이 한꺼번에 그렇게 희생을 당했다는 것 정말로 가슴 아픈 일이 아닐 수가 없습니다. 바로 그 홀로코스트 사건을 조각품으로 작품을 만들어서 많은 사람들에게 다시 한번 그 홀로코스트의 참상과 아픔을 소개하는 그런 분들이 계십니다. 이분들은 이스라엘 뿐이 아니고요. 캐나다에서 오신 바로 예수를 믿는 크리스찬들인데 이스라엘의 한 시골 작은 마을에 그 작품 전시장을 만들어 놓고 이곳을 찾아오는 많은 분들에게 그 작품들을 소개한다고 합니다. 저는 오늘 그 작품들을 직접 보고 또 작품을 만든 릭 씨를 만나서 왜 이런 작업들을 하시게 되었는지 그 이야기를 직접 들어보도록 하겠습니다. 바로 이곳이 그곳입니다.
릭, Hello, Hi, Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
아, 이게 저 다 우리 릭 씨가 만든 작품들이죠. 여기 뭐 벽도 있고, 이 사람들 조각상도 있는데, 우선 간단하게 이 조각품들과 이 벽이 어떤 의미가 있는지 그것부터 잠깐 좀 설명을 해주시겠습니까?
Sure. What you're looking at, we call the Fountain of Tears. This is a dialogue of suffering between the crucifixion and between the Holocaust. What we've taken are the seven last words of Jesus, spoken out of his last minutes of life on the earth, and in a way, put them in front of the Holocaust and the questions of suffering from within the Holocaust.
자, 우선 그러면 좀 가까이 가서 좀 하나부터 예, 좀 들어보도록 하겠습니다. 이분은 기둥에 이 손을 대고 이렇게 있어요. 이게 좀 어떤 의미가 있습니까?
The Holocaust figure within the bronze is representing the survivor. There's always two parts to the Holocaust relationally. You have the survivor and you have the person who perished, or the 6 million that perished. The survivor always feels a connection with those that died. And so this figure is responding to the word from the crucifixion, Father, forgive them, they don't know what they do. Within Jewish thinking, the word forgiveness, there's a huge controversy within the word forgiveness. But the way Jesus spoke forgiveness is that if we receive this to ourselves, we have to give it out. Forgiveness has to come to us, will come to us through him. But as a covenant of forgiveness, it demands that we give it out. So the figure is struggling. He's leaning into the memory of the 6 million that are represented within the stones. The water coming over the stones represents the tears of those that perish, the prayers, the mourning. But in a sense, he's receiving forgiveness to himself. He's holding his chest, but he's struggling. Because in a way, most survivors will say, if I forgive, there's a possibility that those that perished will be forgotten. And so he's leaning into the stones that represent those and dealing with the place, this covenant of forgiveness for himself.
작품 설명 정말 잘 들었습니다. 이 작품들을 만들려면 아무래도 이제 홀로코스트에 대한 그 아픔을 온몸으로 다 영적으로 그걸 느껴가면서 작업을 해야 될 것 같은데 제가 알기로는 이제 릭 씨는 이스라엘 사람이 아니고 캐나다 분이시란 말이에요. 캐나다 분이 왜 이스라엘에 오시게 됐고 또 어쩌다가 홀로코스트 아픔에 그렇게 깊은 관심을 갖고 이런 작업을 하시게 되기까지 그 과정을 좀 소개를 해주시죠.
The journey was so hard. The Lord kept speaking to me in 2001. Kept saying the word over and over again that I am going to pay back. I am going to give back to them what was taken from them in the Holocaust. And I kept feeling the Lord kept on saying, I'm going to take the number 6 million, that is a number that represents death to the Jewish people. And he kept on communicating that I'm going to turn this number into a number that represents life. And I was like, oh Lord, I don't get it. This is way outside of my thinking. This is way too deep, way too far. It's like, how do I touch the Holocaust? And in 2001, I'd been living in Israel 24 years, all right? I'd lived on kibbutz that had lots of people that had gone through the Holocaust. They had become my friends. The Holocaust was one of the main things that brought me to Israel. How did Israel survive the Holocaust in only 3 years becoming a nation? I wasn't a believer then. I became a believer in Israel because I was searching for God, because I was convinced that it must be because of Him that they survived the Holocaust and then survived becoming a nation. I thought it could only be an act of God. And then I wasn't a believer, I was a total pagan, but this connection, this sunk in. That's what brought me to Israel in the beginning. But I had lived here through a miracle. I ended up getting permanent residency. I did my time in the army here. And in the end, again, a miracle, I was given citizenship here as a non-Jew. But in 2001, when the Lord, for me as an artist, the Lord starts to push me into touching this place of suffering within the Holocaust, I thought, this is nuts. This is insane. How do I at one point in this struggle, back and forth with the Lord, I thought, I can't do this. The Holocaust is a place of darkness, only filled with questions. How can I create if all I have is darkness and questions? I can't. And I said to the Lord, I'm not Jewish. There was no one in my family that went through the Holocaust. So it isn't a part of who I am. And I said, I'm from Canada. Canada geographically was separated from the Holocaust. If I'd have been born in France or in Brussels or somewhere in Europe, even as a non-Jew, I would have national memory. And so in a sense, I said to the Lord, I can't do this. I don't have a place to even start. Within that moment, I felt so strong. So strong, the Lord spoke to me, and I felt Him say 3 words. He said, but I do. But I do. I have a memory of every child, every man, every woman, every train car, every cry from every gas chamber. I have a memory of it all. You create from my memory, not from yours. And for me, at that moment, that was the turning point.
어떤 분이 중국에서 온 여행자들을 데리고 예루살렘에 있는 야드바셈을 투어를 시켜주면서 예전에 600만 명의 유대인들이 이렇게 대학살을 당했습니다라고 설명을 했더니 중국 관광객들이 하는 말이 600만 명 정도 가지고 뭘 그러냐 이렇게 얘기를 했다고 그러더라고요. 사실 또 그러면서 뭐라고 얘기하냐면 그 이전에도 오랜 이 인류 역사 속에서 세계 각국에서 600만 명이 죽는 홀로코스트 못지않은 대학살들이 여러 번 있었다 이렇게 얘기를 하는데 다른 대학살과 이 홀로코스트 어떤 차이가 있습니까?
Yeah, this has been brought to me a number of times over the years that there was also genocide in Cambodia and genocide in Rwanda, and there's all kinds of places within human history. And yeah, for sure, the Chinese can look at the number 6 million and say that's not a very big number. But it's interesting that one of the things that I look at is the sense of memory. For the Jewish people within Europe, you have to look at it from a percentage point of view, that over 2/3 of all the Jews in Europe were killed within 6 years. But if you look at the Holocaust, there was never in the history of man, ever, ever, a place produced like Auschwitz-Birkenau. With the design to systematically, they were hoping to be able to kill up to 25,000 Jews a day. This was their hope. They managed within all the production, because they related it to like a factory of death. The maximum that Auschwitz came to was 10,000 Jews a day, specifically Jews. There's never been in the history of man anywhere that death has been so manufactured, ever. And specifically against a particular people group, which was the Jewish people. And you look at it, the Holocaust was something so focused specifically on Jews. Wasn't because they were good Jews, bad Jews, tall Jews, religious Jews, German Jews, national Jews, communist Jews. All Jews in the mind of Hitler was sent to Auschwitz. Was always, that was the focus, was to kill all the Jews, every single one. But out of that place, Israel is born as a nation 3 years after. But I mean, so many points of memory have been created. This is one point of memory within this place. But you've got Washington, and you've got every major city in the United States, almost every major city in Europe, all have points of memory towards the Holocaust. And I look at it and I think, this is outside of the realm of man. Yes, men love to create monuments and all kinds of things, but all these other atrocities don't have international memory, points of memory attached. I believe this is also God's motivation, that this memory will be examined by all the nations of the world, because he is attached to them as a people, and his attachment and his relationship and his memory has to be seen within this, because there is so much of it everywhere.
홀로코스트의 피해 당사자인 유대인들은 자기들을 이렇게 공격했던 자들이 로마 카톨릭이다, 히틀러도 기독교인이다, 이렇게들 생각하고 있다고 얘기를 들었습니다. 그 사람들 중에 하나인 기독교인들, 우리 릭 씨도 기독교인인데 크리스찬인 릭 씨가 이렇게 홀로코스트의 아픔을 기리는 이런 작품들을 만드는 것을 피해 당사자인 유대인들이 와서 보고는 뭐라고 얘기를 하던가요?
We've had whole groups of Holocaust survivors that have come. We've had individual Holocaust survivors. We've had groups of Israeli businessmen. Almost every single time, the survivors, in a way, surprise us. They thank us, which always surprises me. They thank us for trying to touch their place of suffering, their place of memory. That always throws me. With the Israelis who are children of the Holocaust, of Holocaust survivors, or even grandchildren, there's always a sense of shock. We've had people come and say to us, and just having a very strong emotion, they will say, you've taken the two hardest things in our history and you've put them at the same table together. This is insane. This is insane what you have done. I've heard the word mitulaf, which is Hebrew for insane, many times. Other people might say it's insane, get mad, and walk away. With Israelis, they come. They want to know why. Why did you do this?
How could you possibly? I had an Israeli businessman one time come to me and point at the crucifixion panel and say, it's like you've made him, and it was even hard for him to say the word him, it's like you've made him one of us. You've made him one of us. And I look at him and I said, yeah, he is. He's a Jew, just like you. If Jesus, Mary, all the disciples were living in Poland during the 40s, they would all have been sent to Auschwitz, all of them. And you look at it and you think, he is one of you. He's connected to your suffering. He is a part. He is, in a way, Joseph. You don't recognize, just like the brothers didn't recognize Joseph, but in the end, he's one of the brothers. You intended it for evil. God intended this for good. It's the mystery, the tension of how God thinks and how we think. How we understand things, how God understands things. It's a constant conflict.
사실 홀로코스트의 직접적인 가해자라 그러면 이제 로마 교황청과 또 독일 나치 히틀러라고 볼 수 있고 우리 기독교인들은 사실은 이 유대인들에게 직접적인 어떤 폭력을 가하지 않았다 이렇게 볼 수 있는데 그럼에도 불구하고 기독교인들이 이 유대인들이 당했던 홀로코스트에 대해서 책임감을 느껴야 한다면은 어떤 부분에서 우리가 책임감을 느껴야 한다라고 이렇게 보십니까?
There's so much where a veil has been put over the hearts of the Jewish people. So they don't understand. God himself has made them enemies of the gospel for the sake of the Gentiles. Somehow within the thinking of God, this history of how things have developed are the way they are. But it's interesting because for most Jews, the world is divided into three parts, main parts. You're either a Jew, or you're a Christian, or you're a Muslim. And they look at Germany that was Protestant, not Catholic, was Protestant, driving the Holocaust. But they also, I know some Jewish intellectuals that will also say, we know that it wasn't the Christians that did the Holocaust. It wasn't the Christians. It was the Nazi movement within Germany. But I had a woman one time say to me, I don't hate Christians because they did the Holocaust. I hate Christians because of their silence. Because of their silence. For the Jew, Europe was the center of all Christianity. All Christianity came out of Europe. And in Europe, 6 million Jews from every country in Europe are put on train cars. Whole communities that had been in particular countries in Europe for almost Poland, almost 1,000 years of Jewish minority presence, but very strong presence in that country, whole communities disappear, are being persecuted. Even in the 30s, Roosevelt, the president of America, asked for a huge congress in a place in France called Avignon. Why? Because of the Nazis persecuting the Jews. This is even before the beginning of the war. Roosevelt, all the nations come to the conference and they all speak words of sympathy, but they do nothing. So when she says this, I don't hate them because they did the Holocaust. I hate them for their silence. Because they didn't protest all these countries. They didn't do anything to stop this happening, the Holocaust happening right in the center of Christian Europe. So they have, in a way, they have a good argument.
제가 듣기로는 닉 씨가 어젯밤에 폴란드에서 이스라엘 도착하셨다 그랬어요. 이제 또 저희하고 인터뷰하고 나서 이제 며칠 있다가 다시 또 폴란드로 돌아가신다고 얘기하셨는데 그 폴란드에서 오신 이유가 지금 여기하고 똑같은 그런 내용으로 폴란드 아우슈비츠 앞에 볼케나우에다가 또 만들고 있다 이런 얘기를 하셨어요. 왜 그곳에다가 그런 곳을 만드실 생각을 했고 또 지금 어느 정도 작업이 진행됐고 언제쯤 완성이 될 것 같습니까?
Everything that you see here, there's a few changes, a few little changes, but everything that you see here, we are now building 300 meters from the gates to Birkenau. We bought a small piece of ground in 2012, again, out of a response, feeling like the Lord was saying to us, because I've been many times to Auschwitz, but on one of them, I felt the Lord say to me out of the blue, the fountain will be coming here. And I thought, again, this is crazy. Birkenau, Auschwitz, there's only two places in the whole earth where there was over a million Jews in one place killed. Birkenau, Auschwitz, and Jerusalem. Jerusalem, when Titus destroyed Jerusalem, over a million Jews were slaughtered in Jerusalem. And the only other place in one area that over a million Jews were killed was Auschwitz-Birkenau. One, Jerusalem began the diaspora, and then 3 years after Birkenau, Israel goes back to the land. It's like one begins, one ends, the diaspora. And I look at it, and again, I didn't know any of that. All I'm doing is responding to what I think the Lord is saying to me. So we went through lots of things. It's a massive layers of things, but we bought a piece of property in 2012. It meant building a building. I've never done that before. And in a foreign country with a foreign language was crazy. Every time there was a problem, and there were many problems, the Lord always had sent a solution. There was always a solution. And I kept saying to the Lord, it's okay. This can take a long time. I'm not in a big hurry. I kept feeling over and over again, there will be no delays. But I'm really hoping that we'll have everything finished by the spring of 2018. Because the spring of 2018 is a huge marker of memory for this country and for this people. 70 years. 70 years of Israel being a nation is amazing. That within Birkenau, the place that was to destroy them, becomes the place of a memory. But now a people, a nation born out of that is such, for me, it is such a strong evidence of the heart of the Father. He is faithful to himself. Totally. It's amazing.
이스라엘 건국 70주년이 되는 내년 봄에 600만 명의 유대인들이 끔찍하게 희생당했던 그 홀로코스트의 현장에 그들의 아픔과 그들의 고통을 표현하고 또 그들을 위로하는 의미의 이런 거대한 작품이 완성되는 것 굉장히 의미 있는 일인 것 같습니다. 분명히 하나님께서도 기뻐하시고 눈물을 흘리면서 기대하실 일이라 이렇게 믿고요. 그 일을 위해서 이렇게 춥고 덥고 배고프고 고생스럽지만 계속 해나가시는 우리 닉 씨를 위해서 저도 그렇고 우리 브리드 TV의 시청자들도 그렇고 함께 기도해 드리도록 하겠습니다. 아무쪼록 건강하게 일이 잘 마무리됐으면 좋겠습니다. 오늘 인터뷰해 주셔서 고맙습니다. 감사합니다. Thank you very much.